More than 600 million cases worldwide. COVID has changed the world, but there are still those.
You've never gotten COVID, right?
Yeah, not officially at least.
Who've dodged it.
Sometimes I question it, that I'm surprised that I haven't. I'm fortunate that I haven't, but I don't know why.
COVID Superdodgers, who've been exposed to the virus plenty.
Many times I work in the health field, so I think I'm around it quite often.
But never got sick.
I just put it down to I got the vaccine before I showed any symptoms.
In the U.S., nearly half the population has never reported catching the virus, and some scientists are working to learn why. At the University of California, San Francisco, and Rockefeller University in New York, researchers are studying to see if genetics play a role. Here in Milwaukee at Marquette University, Assistant Professor Dr. Nilanjan Lode studies infectious disease.
There might be something physiologically going on there. And it's good to know.
He thinks physicians could use the genetic information for future medicine, though he doesn't believe people are simply born with super dodger immune systems.
Kind of like the course of your action throughout the life. That helps the immunity to build up slowly because it's not like a one-day stuff. You are acquiring that immunity over time.
What we eat, how often we exercise, where we live, what viruses we've been exposed to, all contribute to one's current immunity. Dr. Mary Beth Graham works in the Division of Infectious Disease at the Medical College of Wisconsin.
I find this to be interesting science. I don't know that it turns into that we can make it translational. They're looking at people's HLA type to see is there something about that HLA type which makes them more susceptible.
HLA are proteins found on most human cells, used by the immune system to recognize which cells belong in the body and which do not. Graham says she too has never gotten COVID, but isn't sure you can chalk it up to her genetics.
You can't say with 100% assuredness I've never seen the virus before because the virus has been here for a couple of years, so what if I could have been exposed a few years ago? Would that antibody still be prevalent?
She also says testing genes is expensive and doesn't see when it comes to COVID how it would help anyone.
It is fascinating, but we can't go in and change our HLA type. It doesn't naturally lead into a new type of treatment.
Both researchers say picking up the virus may be inevitable.
And sometimes you might get COVID, but doesn't mean that you will realize that you have it.
So are there really legitimate COVID super dodgers? No one really knows for sure. Doctors still say your best chance at avoiding serious or even fatal symptoms from COVID is to get vaccinated. But Dr. Lode and Dr. Graham both say the likelihood of someone always dodging COVID is slim.
What's your take on the term COVID super dodger?
It's catchy.
I probably don't believe like people are like really dodging stuff.
As flu, RSV, and other illnesses spread this winter, experts warn having those viruses will lower people's immunity, leaving everyone more vulnerable to COVID. In Milwaukee, Caroline Reinwald, WISN 12 News.